What's up, everyone? I'm Thanos, and today we're traveling to the land of Valthar. We will discover altars, build shrines to make our god the most powerful of all. Altar is a game designed by Vasilis Patroulias and published by the... Red Joker. This is a different story. Our story. Altar, Realms of the Gods, is designed by Vasilis, published by the Red Joker, and managed by Boardgame Stories. So, let's dive into the box and see what's hiding inside. Vasilis will tell us how to play the game.
Yes, each player must choose a god dashboard. They must then take an inactive altar, put it in the corresponding place in their dashboard. This is the God's Realm. And then take in their hands cards, follower cards, as many as the number of players plus one. The number of cards must put face up in the center of the table and all the remaining in the deck pile face down. Finally, the shrine tokens and the altar tokens next to the deck pile in a pool.
So, why is it so important to choose a god?
It's very important because each god has a different ability than the others.
I think it's time to start the game. Who goes first?
Ancient God plays always first. But if there is no Ancient God in the game, first is the oldest in age player and all the other players play clockwise. Each player on their turn must take a new card for their hand. The card must be taken from the faced up cards or from the top one from the deck pile. After that, they must perform one action. There are four available actions. First, they can use the ability text. For example, adventurer card adds one inactive altar to our realm. We take one inactive altar and place it to our realm. Then this card is discarded and we place it faced up in a new discard pile. Second action, they can discard cards to perform a ritual. For a ritual, they need three cards with the ritual symbol. We can discard these cards to take a shrine and build it in our realm.
Why is it so important to give so many cards to build a shrine?
Shrines are a very important part of the game because they are indestructible and they are mandatory for winning the game. Third action, they can use worship cards. Worship cards are the cards with this symbol. The worship cards usually protect the gods from other cards. The worship cards are placed next to the god's realm. When they are next to the realm, the ability is activated. When they are in their hand, they have no effect. A worship card has double ritual value. So, in another turn, a god may want to perform a ritual using a worship card. In this case, a worship card plus one more ritual symbol counts as a shrine. And finally, fourth action is to do nothing, pass, and the next player will play. But keep in mind that the hand limit for each player is six cards.
So there are permanent cards and cards that are discarded?
Exactly. Most of the cards are discarded after use. Worship cards provide permanent support, while there are also free action cards like priestess that each player can use them before or after the main action. For example, I can use the priestess to activate one of my inactive altar.
How many free actions a player can use on their turn?
There is no limit.
Who wins the game?
Winner of the game is the player who fills their realm with shrines and active altars. They must have at least one shrine, up to three, and the rest can be only active altars. Not inactive, only active altars and shrines.
Is there another way to end the game?
Yes, there are two more ways. When there are no more cards to draw, or when all the shrine tokens have been taken.
What happens in case of a tie?
In these occasions, ancient god always win and goddess of love always lose. But if there are no these gods on the game, then the player who has the more shrines is the winner. If there is a tie after this, then the player who builds the last shrine is the winner.
Are there any variants in the game?
Of course. In a game of more experienced players, starting cards can be drafted instead of taken randomly. And they're also a very different game for two players.
That's nice. Do you want to say something else?
Yes, there is also a soul expansion, and soon we will have a pilgrimage expansion.
That's really exciting news.